All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Hopefully, you guys can hear me. I turned the volume up. I did a video before where the volume was very low. So I think the volume should be good now. We're in the red or in the yellow or in the green. We're not all the way at the bottom. Okay. This is, again, thank you guys so much for watching. This is a video that's going to kind of cover a variety of different things. I'll try to be in and out of here in about 10 minutes. But I did a video before that was just about the uniforms. You know, Oregon is unveiling uniforms this next year. We haven't seen any of them yet. I had one guy comment. He's like, this is clickbait. He's like, this whole thing's about the new uniforms. There's no uniforms. There are not. But what we're thinking is from what they've released, they released the video saying that there's might be some retro things, and it sounded like plural, which could be maybe some road uniform retro stuff we haven't seen before, or some new retro that could be different eras, like the Joey Harrington at retro, which we'd love to see, or the, you know, Jeremiah Masoli retro, the diamond plate, or the wings. Any of those things I think would be fantastic. I basically talked for like 10 minutes about that. But I do love the uniforms, and Oregon's known for the uniforms, so why not lean into it, right? Duck baseball is playing, duck softball is playing. There's all different stuff going on for Oregon, so this spring we'll always have something to talk about. Spring football is what most people are concerned with, and that's going to really ramp up here, and we'll get to the spring game end of this month, which will be fantastic. If you guys are interested in doing a little meet and greet, you know, Ranchito Grill is the place to be. They do kind of a comedy show, I think, the night before, if I'm correct. And then after the game, I'll be over there with a variety of other people. It's not like it's just a meet and greet for me personally, but there's a lot of people who are in and around the Ranchito Grill community. Just like the Sports Jack community, Ranchito Grill is the place to be. That's over in Springfield after the spring game. And since there's no baseball game this year after the spring game, I'll have the little party afterward and then go do the thing. But so spring football, I'll do a whole separate video on that, lining up everything about what we need to do for spring football. But today's Friday, and so now you know what you have for the Elite Eight. It was just interesting to see this Creighton game, right? This Creighton-Tennessee game, because, again, this is the game that we thought Oregon would be playing in today. And it would have been a magical experience, obviously. But, you know, Tennessee's a really good team. And, you know, Creighton played really well. They shot the ball well. You know, what could have been, right? And I get it. You know, Oregon would have had a chance possibly to really get it done against against Tennessee, and I think that they would have had a good chance at it. It would have been a close game as well, and it would have come right down to the wire. It's just the tough thing is looking over at the other side, looking over at Purdue going up next, because Purdue looks like a team that's really on a rampage. So I thought that Creighton played really well from their perspective. They did what they needed to do. They just kind of ran out of gas at the very end there, and hats off to Tennessee. I was really impressed with the Oregon State women today. Watched the Oregon State women today, and I thought they played really well against Notre Dame. And I just love that team. I think they're really gritty, and I like their coach. I just like what they've kind of got going on. Of course, I like what Oregon's got going on as well. And I think there's a positivity movement happening at the on the Oregon women's basketball level as well. And it's always kind of interesting. You know, I put on Twitter something like, I like the rivalry, the Oregon-Oregon State rivalry, as much as anybody else. But, you know, I really like this Oregon State women's team. And I have all year. You know, the Oregon women, you know, I'm supportive of everybody, right? I'm supportive of the men's women and the men's and the women's Oregon basketball teams. But, you know, this year, this women's team for the basketball for the Ducks was just really tough. This is a really tough season for them, right? So it was kind of cool to see at the end of the year this women's team for Oregon State do really well. And it also kind of, you know, inspired me to think, hey, man, this could be the Ducks we could be rooting for here instead of sitting here watching the Beavs play. So, but it's a really cool opportunity for the Beavs. They were ranked 10th, I think, in the going into the big Pac-12, which is absolutely absurd. And then they had a great run this year, and they deserve all the flowers. And then also the fact that they're going to have a really tough matchup now with South Carolina. It was also crazy to see from a Duck perspective all these Duck players, former Duck players out there doing crazy stuff and really having the really great games out there. So again, the women's game is really fun. I feel like there's a lot going on with the women's game. It's a pretty fun opportunity. And you know, going from there, it's just on to the next one. So, you've got, NCAA basketball. I think the brackets are, a lot of them are busted. I had Purdue originally, but the Arizona thing I got to talk about because, you know, with this history with Arizona, you know, Arizona is one of those schools that is constantly in really good shape basketball wise. They always have really good crowds. They always have really good buzz. They get a lot of really good publicity from the rest of the country, but they tend to strike out. And again, another one of these years where Arizona just did not come to play in the tournament. And Oregon kind of saw this coming a little bit when we played them in the Pac-12 tournament, where just caught them on a day where it didn't work for them and they didn't work out. And it's just a really interesting situation for them. So it's really tough deal for Arizona. They're going in the Big 12. I had a lot of good conversations with a lot of Arizona fans. Of course, a lot of them are a little rough around the edges maybe when it comes to sportsmanship. But a lot of them I was having really good conversations with where I'm thinking, hey, man, you guys are going to the Big 12 and you're going to have a good run in the Big 12. But the way that they're playing like this at the end of the year, man, I got some questions going into that. So it's going to be an interesting one. But there's a lot going on with Oregon right now. Oregon's doing its own thing, you know, when it comes to, you know, packing up from the Pac-12 and going on to the Big Ten. I think that football-wise is in really good shape. I think basketball-wise is really good shape. You're going to have guys decommit. This guy, Victorious Miller, he decommitted today. Four-star, but, you know, again, you're going to have guys come and go. I think the transfer portal has always been pretty good for Dana, but I think both programs are trending upward, men's basketball and women's basketball has to be trending upward because it bottomed out so hard this year, and then obviously football, but going into the Big Ten, I think the Ducks are in a great shape. It's a tough one right now to think about what these schools are going to do, like Oregon State, for example, having such a good women's basketball team. Are they going to package this thing up and redo this thing next year and in hopes that they're still going to have a conference in the next couple years or whatever the case may be? And then there's also this whole discussion of whether the Pac-2 can really put a squeeze on the Mountain West and take their better teams and create like a Pac-10 again. And whether or not anybody would have any interest or not in that is to be seen. But they're holding out hope. I feel like Washington State and Oregon State are both holding out hope. They're collecting all the checks they can get from all the Pac-10 or Pac-12 participants and all the big dance and anything else that your people are going to throw their way or whatever else the case may be. And they're going to need it because they're going to be out of cash quickly with no conference really to pay them any of the money that they've been paid before in these other conferences. So in Pac-12 especially. Yeah, so it's an interesting situation. And I do think that there might be something to be said about trying to put together a conference that could, you know, maybe rival what the Mountain West is right now. But if Washington State and Oregon State just join the Mountain West right now, I think that's the same as other schools joining them and becoming the Pac-10 or Pac-12. I don't think it changes. I think changing the name is one thing. Changing the schools is not something totally different. And I don't think anybody's going to be really sold on the fact that they're a power conference with the schools that they have in the Mountain West. I just don't think that there's that much respect for that. Now, I do think that there could be some other shakeup in the future where you have some sort of wild situation where all these conferences break up and you have some sort of Western Division or Eastern Division or Southern or Northern or whatever the case may be. But until that happens, I think the Beavs and the Washington State Cougars are really, really in some tough, tough situations and really hot water because there's just nowhere for them to go. And then I saw this last thing here at the end here. Again, we don't do a lot of golf chat in here, but I'm a golfer, I'm a golf coach, and I love Bandon Dunes. And I saw a bunch of Twitter about Bandon Dunes, about the end of about all this stuff about Bandon Dunes, about how it's overrated and the greens are terrible and everything. Now there was some pictures, especially Bandon at two, There's some holes at Bandon Dunes that are not good, some greens that are not good, especially number two at Bandon, par three up on the hill. And, you know, it's one of those things. I've played that course long enough. I played the old tee box. It was, you looked straight at it when you went up to the right there. And then now when you go down the trail, you got to go over to the tee box. Then you got to go up and hike the trail to go up again. That tee box was brutal. I played it in February. That's when my friends go. We go every year. I played it for years now. And to see the transition, it's wild. Every year it feels like a certain course it looks really good, and then another certain course looks really bad. And in this case, Bandon Dunes, my favorite of all the five courses, was in the worst shape. And the greens were in really bad shape. And you know, of course, we played in the winter where you're going to expect some of that anyway because of so much rain. But this year, it just came down in bunches. And I mean, I'm telling you, a lot of sand was lost on the dune across Rockaway, my family's house. I lost about 10 feet of dune there. The El Nino thing is no joke, you know. And so, again, there was just so much rain, and there wasn't enough sunlight to really get a lot of grass growth and whatnot that you needed. And so there were some really tough times there. Now, Sheep Ranch is the newest course of all five of them, and it has not been playing that well because it's such a young course. It needs to mature a little bit. But Bandon Dunes is the oldest course. Bandon Dunes should be in tip-top shape. The course that's playing the best there is actually Old Mac, because it's the course that has the least amount of play, because a lot of people are playing Sheep Ranch instead of playing Old Mac. So Old Mac for the last couple years has kind of been able to rest a little bit. But these courses get a lot of wear and tear. There's a lot of traffic on them. People take the rickshaws over the green and stuff on them. I mean, these greens take a beating. And they're humongous greens as well. The green complexes are just gigantic. So it's there's some tough situations there. It's the middle of the spring. I get it. Guys pay a lot of money to go out there. And it would be a damn shame to go out there for the very first time. You've never played Bandon Dunes ever. And you come out, and you pay $200 a round. You're paying for your lodging and everything else. And there's nothing cheap there. And all of a sudden now you get out to your green and you're like, you're putting, and it's like, what the hell is this? Looks like a parking lot. That would be something that would be tragic. So I get it. For me, from my perspective, I've seen it. I've seen the greens come and go. I've seen I've seen them good. I've seen them bad. This year it was not great, but it is what it is. So you just kind of think on to the next one. So. All right, that was Old School Sports Chat, where you had a bunch of different sports to chat about. Obviously, it's always about Duck football here. It starts and finishes. Duck basketball, you have the rest of March Madness. Everybody's interested in that. Creighton, what could have been. You have the women's program. You have a bunch of different Duck connections with all these other teams. Everybody's got Ducks on their team, it feels like. Former Ducks. I counted about six Ducks, it felt like, from that transfer portal last year. So, you know, hopefully that women's program gets better. And then, of course, you've got everything else that's going out there in the world of sports. And I didn't really talk about any other sports outside of that. So, all right, y'all. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Again, Tuesday night live streams, if you're interested. Tuesday night, 5:30 to 7:30, basically, I run it. And if you have anything to chat about, jump in the chat, man. Thank you guys so much for watching Sports Chat 503. We'll see you guys next time. Of course, as always, go Ducks.